Hello YouTubers, welcome back to my channel. Nanny D here, back with a quick showcase of a figure that I received today. And as you can see, it's Viggo Mortensen, aka Aragorn, from the epic movie Lord of the Rings. The figure is made by the company called ACI, and it's an officially licensed figure. Looks absolutely fantastic. I have to say, I was a little bit surprised. I didn't expect to be that good. I also have to say, I'm not a huge fan of the Lord of the Rings movies, so I wasn't really keen about this figure. But when I saw the in-hand pictures from other fellow collectors, I knew I had to get this one, because this looks so fucking real. It could be a movie still. They nailed it. I mean, the likeness to Viggo Mortensen is fantastic. And especially the rooted hair gives this figure this certain realism. Very, very cool. I'm totally impressed. But not only with the head sculpt, also with the entire outfit. Looks absolutely fantastic. From head to toe, just one beautiful figure. Boots are unfortunately not made of leather or, you know, fabric. They are actually hard plastic, which hinders the articulation here a little bit. So basically you can give him just like this, you know, static, upright, standing pose. So for all you guys who like to go crazy with action poses, you will be a little bit disappointed. But other than that, this figure is just a dream came true for all Lord of the Ring fans. The coat is not made of real leather, it's a fabric that looks like worn and weathered leather, but it's so nice. I mean, wow. I'm really impressed with the tailoring and the texture. It's just beautiful. Paint job on the entire figure and outfit is outstanding. Also love the gauntlets here, they look so cool. Super, super detailed. What I also like about this figure is all the blades. The swords are all made of metal, die-cast metal, so that's very, very cool. You get here the bow and three individual arrows. You can actually pose him like shooting an arrow, so you get extra hands with this certain, you know, kind of pose that he holds the arrow. But the centerpiece is definitely the head sculpt, which is so cool. Now, speaking of the head, this is the only thing I would like to point out here, where I think ACI fucked up big time. The way you see it here, that's not the way you get him out of the box. Out of the box, he comes with way longer hair, like this. And it looks like a Barbie doll. So what you have to do is basically cut and trim the hair by yourself to the length and the shape, you know, that he looks like in a movie. Now, that being said, listen, my friends, very carefully. If you don't know what you're doing, if you have never ever cut rooted hair on a doll before, on a puppet or a figure before, don't do it yourself. If you never ever cut any hair by yourself before, don't touch him. I can promise you, you will fuck it up and you're gonna ruin the figure, because you can't just go on, take a scissor and cut the hair straight. That's gonna look super fucking stupid and goofy. So if you wanna get a haircut like this, you have to, you know, cut in different layers, and it may look just simple, but it's not, trust me. I know what I'm doing. I've been a customizer for many, many years. I cut several, rooted hair pieces, and I also know how to cut hair, real hair, human hair. I'm not a hairdresser, but I know how to do it, okay? So if you have never ever cut that shit by yourself, I don't recommend it to do it because you will fuck it up. So what I do recommend is take the head or the entire figure to your local hairdresser or a barber and let him do it. He might look at you like you've been crazy or something, because I think they never ever had someone taking a 1/6 scale figure for a haircut, but trust me, it's gonna take him like a minute or two and they're gonna give him that look. And it's gonna look great, fantastic, you're gonna enjoy your figure. If you're doing it yourself, you're gonna ruin it and you're gonna fuck it up and you're gonna regret it, okay? So if you know what you're doing, go ahead and do it. If you don't, take it to a professional and let him do it, okay? So, that being said, there's nothing more left to the figure. I almost forgot. What you also get with the figure is this cape, you know, with a hoodie and this kind of leaf buckle. It's made of, you know, sort of a suede-y material. It's nicely weathered. Looks very cool on the figure, so you can display him either with cape or without cape. Me personally, I like it better without cape, because if you put the cape on, a big part of the figure gets covered, so you don't see all the details. But it looks fantastic both ways. I mean, you know, maybe you can change it a while in this style and then another, the other style. Both looks cool, but like I said, I prefer this look better. The box is nothing special. Says Lord of the Rings and has this sort of leather texture, like a green leather texture. You got here images of the figure, and on the back the credits and all the usual stuff. It's a nice sturdy box with a magnetic closure here. And in the inlay, or as inlay, you get here this nice sketch of Aragorn, which you may use as a backdrop picture. Looks pretty nice. And oh yeah, and also what comes with the figure is this torch, which I'm not really happy about it. I think it's kind of difficult to sculpt or recreate flames, you know, in plastic form. What I should have done is made it more kind of yellowish orange and not as red as this. Because remember back in the day when I had the Ghost Rider figure, that looked actually pretty cool. But this just doesn't do the job for me. I mean, if you like it, you may display him with the torch. I don't like it. I will definitely not gonna use it. So yeah, that's basically it. I hope you enjoyed and liked this little review. Like I said, for all the guys who have this piece coming, you will be super, super pleased. And for all other guys who haven't bought it yet, I highly recommend to get it, because I can guarantee you this will be a figure that's gonna be sold out, if not already sold out, very fast, and it's gonna cost a fortune in a couple of months. So grab him while you can. Keep collecting. Enjoy your hobbies and see you around on the tube. Bye bye.